To understand the direction of the real estate market, we feel that we need to have an understanding of the economy. And for us, the big six internal economic indicators that we track include Toronto's unemployment rate, which has decreased 25% over the last 5 years and currently sitting at 5.8%. The inflation rate, which is currently 1.9% and well within the Bank of Canada's target rate of 1-3%. Annualized GDP, which advanced 3.7% this past quarter, which is good. Immigration and population growth, which remain very strong for Toronto. And then you've got the prime rate, which is currently 3.95% tied to mortgage rates, which are extremely low. And finally, mortgage delinquency rates for Canada at 0.23%, Ontario at 0.09%, which are both a stark contrast to the US's 2.59% mortgage delinquency rate. Now, let's dig a little deeper into downtown Toronto housing stats, and not the stats that most realtors and that the Toronto Real Estate Board talks about every single month. Averaging the entire GTA, you can see that there was a correction between 2017 and late 2018, but downtown, there really wasn't a price correction. There was a pause. The peak in prices is right now. Our inventory levels are extremely low. In a balanced market, we would have 4 to 5 months of inventory, but right now, we have less than 1.5 months of inventory for almost all housing types. Average days on market, again, for all housing types, hovering between 11 and 16 days. And finally, for the sake of this video, there are approximately 38,000 new condos under construction in the downtown core. And from my previous chart, you can see why I say we need more. Average resale condo prices are $969 a square foot. Unsold new construction condos at $1,292 a square foot. We're happy to dive into more charts and stats for our new and existing clients in an ongoing effort to keep our people informed and two steps ahead of the crowd.